Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Alain Equestrian Shooting and Golf Club, where the second leg of this year's ISSF World Cup in Shotgun events is taking place from the 17th through the 24th of April. Filling in the capacity of the range, 350 athletes are coming here to compete from 50 countries, and they will be competing in the five Olympic shotgun events in the next days. Today we are following the final for the trap woman event. I'm Marco Dalladea, and commentating with me today is Susan Atras from Canada, seven-time world champion in this event. Hi Susan, and welcome to ISSF TV again.
Thank you, Marco. It's wonderful to be here.
So we are in Al Ain in the United Arab Emirates, where this competition is taking place. We have a few new rules coming in this year. The sport has been changing since last year. Susan, what's happening?
Well, what they've done is that they've restricted in the... This is now going to be called a semi-final, and the women and the men will shoot from three positions, post two, three, and four. And then they'll shoot 15 shots, and then the top four, well, the top two will shoot off against each other for the gold and silver, and the next two will shoot off for third and fourth.
So here are our six finalists of today who are getting ready for this semi-final, the new final phase of the Trap Woman event. We are shooting today with a clear sky. It's 5 in the afternoon here in Al Ain, so the light is a little bit strange. What can we say about the lightning here, about the light?
Well, it's really challenging. I mean, when you look at it, it looks so beautiful, but it's really challenging. And it's going to be very interesting to see how they do in the one shot.
So let's present our finalists. You have just seen Carole Corminier of France. She's a very young shooter, 23-year-old. Today it's her first major final. She has never been competing in a final. And here is Catherine Skinner from Australia. She's 23 years old as well. She won a bronze medal in Sydney in 2011, shooting at the Oceanian Championship. And she will be shooting in the final today. And here is Jana Beckham of Germany, a skilled young shooter, 29-year-old. She has been competing in the final in Acapulco at the previous World Cup stage just 3 weeks ago. She's in again, and she will be facing Jessica Rossi of Italy, the reigning Olympic champion, the winner of the 2012 Olympic Games in London, who was also competing and shooting and finishing on the podium in Acapulco at the beginning of the year. From Australia, the second Australian shooter in today's final, 22 years old, Laetisha Scanlan, also competing in her first major final in an ISSF World Cup stage, but she has been winning the 2011 Oceanian Championship. And here is the last finalist for today, Charlotte Kerwood of Great Britain, a two-time Olympian, who has been finishing a few times on ISSF World Cup podiums in 2007 and in 2006. So, Susan, what can we say about today's finalists? Quite a young group of people.
I was going to say the first thing is they're young. Jana is the oldest at 29?
I think so, yeah, she's 29.
Yeah, so this is the youngest women's final we've had in years.
So why do you think, we have seen that also in Acapulco, we have so many new young shooters coming into the game and making it to the finals. What do you think?
What happens every year after Olympics? So whether it's 2004, 2005 after 2004, or 2009 after 2008, there's a huge change. A lot of people retire, sometimes forced, sometimes just by their own choice. There's coaching changes, and when you have coaching changes, then that provides different opportunities for shooters. It's always in all the years I've been doing this, 44 years, and there's always, it's a new cycle. Whoops.
So let's start with the game. Carole Corminier of France is missing her very first target. There's a slight wind coming from the left side of the range. Do you think that will affect the targets?
Yes, it has been. And today we were shooting in a headwind, so that was affecting it too, blowing at the target.
And we are now on Jana Beckham, the left-handed shooter from Germany, who is hitting her very first target. She looks very focused today after making it in the final in Acapulco. You've been shooting against her today.
Yeah, we were on the same squad. And so was Catherine Skinner, and both women shot it really well, even in all the bad, you know, the wind and the heat, and they did well.
And here is the first shot of Jessica Rossi, who is hitting a first target. The Olympic champion made it to the podium at the first World Cup of the year in Acapulco.
Yeah, she came, got the silver medal.
She got the silver medal.
Yes. And here's Charlotte.
Oh. Charlotte Kerwood starting off with a miss, but she's raising her hand. But referee says...
Oh, they're stopping.
Yeah, they're stopping the match.
She has appealed it, and that's what you do. The referee doesn't seem to... He's asking the side refs, which he's supposed to do, as to why. And so she has put up her hand saying that she is appealing that. She did exactly what she was supposed to.
And now even the second side referee is saying it's a miss.
Yes.
So it will be given a miss, isn't it?
Yes. Now, this is setting, I believe, number 7. All day we shot setting number 3, and they were all high targets. So setting 7 is a bit different, and so we'll see the target.
So that was the worst target to start with, isn't it?
Well, no, it was a high target. The worst target is what Carol Carol had that sharp right off of 2, and that is a tough target.
Because of the angle and...
And angle and the height and visibility. Oh, and she missed the next one, which was a high target.
So it's a 2 miss for France, Carole Kamenier.
And Catherine...
Yeah, we are on Catherine Skinner hitting her second target. She had started with a miss this semi-final.
And here's Jana on her next shot.
And she's hitting her second target out of 15. As we said, rules have been changing. So we are now following the semi-finals, where our shooters will compete on 15 targets. After the semi-final, top 2 will advance to the medal match for gold, while the 3rd and 4th ranked will advance to the bronze medal match. And after every competition phase, the score is set back to 0, as you said before.
Yes. So I was wrong. They're on setting 3, which is a lot of high targets. And Jessica Rossi just missed a very high to the right, which unfortunately I missed a lot today too.
So
Laetitia hit hers.
Does the wind affect more this high target than the low sharp ones?
I think it does. Oh, and Charlotte hit that one very well.
And you can see how the smoke of the flash target is fading away really, really quickly. That shows that there's a bit of breeze blowing in the range here today.
And also, there's more wind out where the targets are being thrown than there is here, because we have the wind protecting the shooters.
So it's even,
all right,
it's even
Carol hit her very sharp left, so that was good. And now we have Catherine. Now, Catherine's coach... And Laetitia's coach, the national coach, is a Russian by the name of Valery Timokhin. And he was a skeet shooter.
He has been in the business for a while, isn't it?
Yeah, he has. I remember competing when he was competing.
And here's Jana back now.
And Jana's coach is Axel Kramer. And he was a skeet shooter. But we won't hold that against them. There's a running competition between, running friendly battle between skeet and trap shooters.
And what about Jessica Rossi?
Okay, now who is...
She's Jessica Rossi now is on post number 3.
Okay, now Jessica Rossi's coach is Albano Pera, and Albano was an excellent trap shooter. And when he retired from shooting, he took on the national coach's job. And she just missed that, and that was a high one again.
Again, a second high target in a row that she's missing in this final.
Well, what's
going to
be
start for
Jessica
Rossi?
But what's going to be interesting to see is the color of their glasses, because the visibility is really difficult.
As you said at the beginning, the light is a little bit strange, I would say. There are some shadows casted into the field of play.
It's not really. What it is from the trap house. Oh, and Charlotte missed that one.
So the beginning of this semi-final,
So what it, the problem is when it leaves the bunker, it's really difficult. The green of the bunker goes into the green of the grass, and right there it's really difficult. And then if it goes into the sky, which all there's so many high targets here, it's really hard to see it. And so a lot depends on your color of glasses.
So after the first three targets, Jana Beckham of Germany is leading the match, tied to Australia's Scanlan. They both hit all three targets thrown so far, and we are going now in the next three targets. Let's see Catherine Skinner of Australia hitting her fourth target, and here is Jana Beckham currently leading the match. Not a miss so far. Jana Beckham calling the target and hitting.
She got that high one to the right.
She looks really confident today, doesn't she?
Oh yeah, she was during the whole event. I mean, she was the leadoff person, and then Catherine Skinner was second. And both shot really well. I want to point out that the scores shot today, Charlotte had a 74, Laetitia had a 73, Jessica had a 72, and then four women tied with 71. And Melanie Cousy of France didn't make the, they had to shoot off the 71s,
and she dropped out. And here's Jessica Rossi back on focus. She's hitting her fourth target, now focus on Laetitia Scanlan, hitting as well. She's leading the match tied to Jana Beckham at the moment. These two girls have been fighting head and head since this morning's qualification, and they are tied again here in the semi-final. We are looking for the two top shooters to move on to the gold medal match, where the gold and silver medal will be decided after 15 semi-final targets. And here we are now on Carole Cormenier of France.
Carol, when she shot her 71, she shot a 23, 25, 23, which is excellent. I mean, these women shot really well today, and people have to understand how hot. Yesterday it was 37 Celsius.
So it's extremely difficult to be consistent throughout the competition with these weather conditions, isn't it?
Well, you just have to be really smart, and so they've got good coaching staff that are making sure that they're getting they're keeping hydrated, they're keeping cool with water, or keeping cool with scarves and that kind of stuff. So that's really important. Catherine had a no bird, so she's setting up again.
And it looks like that the wind is picking up a bit at the moment.
I hate to disagree with you again, but no, I don't think it is. It's just, it's been just switching around a bit. And she hit that one really nicely. It was a sharp left off of four that a lot of us swore at today.
And once again on Jana Beckham, and here is a nice front shot of the throwing machine.
And she hit that one.
She's really focused.
Yeah, and now they're switching. And Charlotte Kerwood, the national coach for Great Britain, is Kevin Gill, and Kevin was a very good trap shooter and competed in many world championships and world cups, and successful. And
so what do you think? Behind a successful shooter, there's always a successful coaches.
Well, you know, it's usually there's it's a combination. I think a good coach and a good athlete gives you good results.
And here Laetitia Scanlan, fifth target, fifth hit. She looks unstoppable today, and now
well,
we are on
still
Charlotte
early.
Cupboard.
It's still early. And unfortunately, Charlotte missed that target. Charlotte's experiencing what Jana Beckman did in Acapulco. You know,
getting
she
into
came
the
in
final.
Final with a 74 out of 75, and then having problems in the final. But this is, I think, Charlotte's first attempt at it. So anyway, Carol's coach. The French have a new coach. His name is Paolo Donato, and he's an Italian, and he's just started with the French. And I mean, he had two women in the top seven, so I think
he's doing a good job.
I think he's doing a good job. Yes.
And we just saw a hit from Carole Cormenier. Now Catherine Skinner, the second Australian shooter in the final today, hitting her fifth target, four hits out of five thrown targets so far, but pressure back on Jana Beckham now. Beckham calling the target and clearing it.
Now they're switching again. So one of the things about the Australians is they have had really good women shooters over the years, starting way back, you know, with Desiree Bain, it was Huddleston and then Bain, and then Susie Bello, the Olympic gold medalist in 2004. Australia, they've got really good women shooters.
And
they're always tough.
This looks like a new generation of young Australian shooter.
It is, and they're good. I first met them at the World Championships in Slovenia, and they're good.
And here's Jessica Rossi hitting a sixth target, the Italian shooter.
What she hit?
No,
it was a no
she's
bird.
She's been appealing.
No, it was a no
it was
bird.
It was a no bird. She disagreed with that. But she will have to shoot again, isn't it?
Yes. If it's no bird, it has to be repeated. So she's setting up again.
How stressful it is when you just think you have been hitting the target, but the referee calls a no bird, and you have to redo that.
Well,
how frustrating is that?
You really have to take a moment, and she's doing it. She's smart, and she's taking the time to reset her mind.
How many seconds do they have to? Are they allowed to take?
12 seconds, and she just missed it.
And Jessica Rossi losing her concentration
and that's
now.
No, I don't think so. It was just a sharp target. It was a sharp left.
She has been hitting three targets out of the first six. And yes, Charlotte Kerwood on her sixth target. A clear hit.
Okay.
And now we are changing again. And here you can see the standings after the first six targets. Jana Beckham and Laetitia Scanlan are still leading tied with six hits out of six targets. Catherine Skinner of Australia is following now in third place with five hits, while Carole Comenier of France is following in fourth with four hits. Jessica Rossi and Charlotte Kerwood are now tied in fifth and sixth place with three hits out of six targets, and they are in a dangerous position because, as we said, top two will advance to the gold medal match.
Yeah.
The third and the fourth will advance to the bronze medal match, and the last two will drop out and place in fifth and sixth place.
Now, looking at Carol, I want to let you know that she shoots a Guarini shotgun, and she is using RC4 ammunition. And unfortunately, she just missed that
target.
And Catherine Skinner is shooting a Beretta DT11. It's a new gun this year, and shooting RC4 ammunition. And Jana Beckman is shooting a Zoli shotgun and Hubertus ammunition.
And here she's calling the target. The left-handed shooter misses it. It's the first miss for Jana Beckham. Maybe it's a turning point of this final, because the pressure is now on Scanlan. If she hits this target, she will move up in the lead alone with one target of advantage.
Yeah,
let's
we'll
follow
see.
Now.
It's a long way. Still
it's a long way through.
Okay, now Jessica Rossi shoots a Perazzi MX-8. And Fiocchi ammunition. And she shoots them well.
She's
our
yes,
reigning Olympic champion.
Yes, she does. She has been showing her skill at the 2012 Olympic Games, where she led the competition, finishing with a new record of 99 hits, just one
and
target Laetisha, from perfection.
Laetisha Scanlan hit that target, and she shoots a Beretta DT11 and RC Redshot cartridges.
And yes, Charlotte Kerwood.
And Charlotte hit hers, and Charlotte is shoots a Perazzi MX-2000 and RC-4. So we get a nice variety.
It's a nice variety, and it's the second time we see a Guerini in the final this year, as the skeet shooter Hill, who won the skeet woman event in Acapulco, was shooting a Guerini. And I think it's...
Oh, Carol
we
had a problem there.
That so often. And here Carol is missing.
Yeah.
Moving on now to Catherine Skinner of Australia.
She hit that one nicely. So Catherine, after missing her first target, has gone straight for seven more.
She's quite new in big finals. Do you think that the stress of being part of such a big event could have affected her first shot?
Not at all. This kid is good. I mean, she has great concentration. I mean, I've watched her shoot before at the World Championships in Slovenia. I got her to shoot double trap, and then the little turkey beat me. She came third, and I came fourth. But she's a good shooter.
She is.
And so is Laetitia. I mean, they're strong shooters. Here we have Jessica Rossi again. Speaking of strong shooters.
Pressure back on Rossi, calling the target and hitting it straight.
But she's getting the bottoms of it. If you'll notice, well, Okay, now Laetitia's right on them. But sometimes Jessica's getting the backhand, and that could be just because the targets are high. Oh. All right.
And here's Charlotte Cabot hitting a eighth target, 5 hits out of 8 targets so far for the British champion.
Yeah.
And here you can see the shooting range of Alain.
Yeah, it's a beautiful range. I have to comment that this is just a beautiful range.
A great organization, a great range here in Alain in the United Arab Emirates, a venue which has already been hosting a World Cup final in 2011, and I know they are keen to organize more competition in the future.
Catherine has her head, her hat put on an angle so that she doesn't get the sun, because which is very smart.
Because at the moment the sun is going down on the left side of the range.
And you look at poor Jana's looking right into it. Well, not right. It's right in her face.
And it's a second miss for Jana Beckham. 7 hits out of 9 targets. She lost the leadership. She lost the lead of this match.
Yeah, I mean, Laetitia is shooting brilliantly. But Laetitia has a good... In the 2010 Commonwealth Games, she shot brilliantly, too. And I believe in the team event, they won the gold medal.
Yep, Laetisha Scanlan is a gold medalist at the 2011 Sydney Open Championship.
And Jessica hit that one nicely.
And yes, Laetisha Scanlan hitting the target. So she has 9 hits out of 9 targets. So she's leading the match with 1 target of advantage on her followers. Yes, Charlotte Kerwood clearing this 9th target. So after the first niner,
two Aussies, and first and second.
Yeah, two Aussies in first and second. After the first 9 target, Laetitia Scanlan is leading with 9 hits. Full score, Catherine Skinner is following in second with 8 hits. Just 1 miss for her. Jana Beckham of Germany, after missing 2 targets in the last 3 clays, dropped down in third place with a total of 7 hits. Jessica Rossi is right there. With 6 hits tied to Charlotte Kerwood of Great Britain.
So this last 6 will be very will determine just how nervous people are if they aren't.
It's the final sprint, the last 6 target to determine.
See, Catherine, that was great. She put the gun up, wasn't ready, she brought it right down. And that's, it looks easy, but it's really hard to stop yourself. When you to know if you're not
so you mean
quite
it's,
ready.
It's not so easy to stop your routine and
exactly.
Start it again.
Yeah. And she did a great job.
Here's Jana Beckham.
Good shot. That's that awful left off of 4.
So at the moment, with this sun coming down on the left side, left angle target would be more difficult, isn't
it? Yes, that's right.
Because the sun is right in their eyes when they're turning on that side.
Yeah. And what happens, it becomes sort of a dark thing. You don't really see it as well
as you'd like to. And here's Jessica Rossi.
Now you'll notice that Jessica Rossi has got clear lenses on.
Compared to the other girls who have darker shaders.
Yeah, well, and now watch Laetitia. She has dark lenses, but...
It's working fine for her.
Oh, yeah. And according, you know, it's... And then see, Charlotte has a lighter lens.
It looks like that the two shooters with the lighter lens are now in 5th and 6th place.
Yeah.
So changing again, with the new rules, we are only competing on station number 2, 3, and 4.
Carol has really dark lenses, and I'm betting they may be a little too dark,
given the conditions. Even
but she shot that one well.
During the day, the light was really sharp, wasn't it?
Yeah.
You have been shooting out there. How's the weather condition to shoot?
Well, I mean, it's hot. And unless you're used to it, it can be quite daunting. But and Catherine hit that one nicely. It can be quite draining. But the conditions were beautiful. But today, you know, we had wind for the first round and wind at the end of the third round. In the middle, the second round, not as much. So what
we are moving now on to the 11th target.
So Jessica, when she shot today, she shot a 72, and she had a 24, 24, 24.
So really consistent.
Pretty consistent, very consistent.
Jessica Rossi And here's a clear view of the throwing machine in front of the trap.
Yeah, and that awful left-handed target into
as
the sun.
Said, as you said, that's probably getting the most difficult angle here today.
Oh, yeah. Because it's, it is tonight. Yeah, because it's the way you're looking into the sun.
And here again, Laetitia Scanlan, the young Australian shooter who is leading today's match now with 11 hits out of 11 targets.
And Laetitia today shot a 24, 24, and a 25. Whoa. So she's
hard to beat.
And Charlotte shot a 24 and then a 50 straight, which was just excellent. But it's, you know, it's hard going from a 50 straight into a final.
It's new rules are for sure not helping her today.
No.
And here is Carole Courmenier of France.
And Carole shot a 23, 25, 23. I mentioned that earlier. But she shot well. I mean, for her first World Cup, I think she did brilliantly.
That pressure in the final. She only hit so far 8 targets out of 11, out of 12.
And Catherine hit those. You know, she missed her first one and has gone straight ever since.
I mean, yeah, it's Jana Beckham. She has been leading the match until the 6th target, dropping then 2 out of 3 targets.
I couldn't even see that target. That's how hard it is. That was that sharp left.
The sharp left, it's the target which everybody would like to avoid in today's final with these difficult light conditions, making the game more challenging.
Yeah.
And here's Jessica Rossi now shooting on station number 3. The Italian.
On 4.
On 4, the Italian shooter.
And she had a no bird.
Just had a no bird. Jessica Rossi taking her time before mounting the gun again.
Yeah, that's really important to do. And a lot of people, if they have a broken target, will rush it. And that's where they make a mistake. They've got to really, you know, just regroup and make sure you're
And Jessica Rossi seems to be really focused, really concentrated. They shooter calls the target. And it's another no bird, I think.
Oh, okay, good. Because it looked like it was a lost target, so that's good.
I may be wrong, but she will be repeating that target. It was a no bird.
Yeah. And that's the high right.
So now Rossi knows where the targets are normally random, but now Jessica Rossi knows where that target is going to fly. Does that help the shooter, or does that
it all depends
put more
if
pressure on it?
If you've trained in it, you're fine. If some people don't like to know, and they have a hard time with it. I'm sure, knowing Albano, that she has trained with that.
They've been training
with that. So she hit that really nicely.
I've been talking with her before the start of the World Cup season, and she told me that after the Olympics she has been carrying on a lot of exercise rather than shooting full rounds. So
yeah.
I'm sure she has been training on this special situation. And
see,
Charlotte Kerber
missed that terrible left off of 3 like everyone else has been doing, other than Laetitia.
Laetitia is just going straight. So after the first 12 targets, Laetitia Scanlan of Australia is still leading with a full score of 12 hits out of 12 targets. She seems to be unbeatable today. Her teammate, Catherine Skinner, is following in second, just 1 target behind with a total score of 11 hits. While Jana Beckham, the German, the 29-year-old German shooter, follows in third with a total of 9 hits. So it looks like when only 3 targets are left to be thrown, it looks like that the two top shooters are defined, isn't it?
Oh, see again, that left-handed target Carole missed. And that's the one, it's a high one off of post 2. Now here's Catherine.
Catherine Skinner.
Oh, broken target. So here you get a really good view of the, oh shoot, my papers flew away with the wind.
But here. And here the wind is affecting not only the shooters, but the commentators as well.
But what I was trying to say is what the background. It's a beautiful background. It's just gorgeous. But
it's that difficult line between the trees and the sky where you can lose the target.
Yeah, and a lot of people will lose it as it comes out of the house. Oh, she hit that one. Great. That's that sharp left off of 4.
Jana Beckham hitting difficult target, and now it's the change again. We go on for the last 3 targets. The last 3 targets, but we'll decide who is making it to the gold medal match, who's advancing to the bronze medal match.
If Laetisha hits her first target, then she's definitely
she will be in.
Yep.
She has, at the moment, two targets of advantage on the third, on Jana Beckham. So
yeah.
One target will be enough to be sure to be in the medal matches. And yeah, Jessica Rossi hitting a...
That sharp left.
Laetisha
hit that, so she's in the gold medal match.
Laetisha Scanlan is the first medal match contender of today's
and Charlotte
semifinal.
Hit that awful left off of four. Good for her.
Another change. Moving on with the competition, we are in the final phase. Last two targets to be thrown to decide the medal match participant. Carole Cormenier, she's most probably out of the games with 8 hits out of 12
targets.
Oh, she
hit that one. That was good. That sharp left. Oh, she just gave a huge sigh. I just saw it. And I can bet she's happy to be finished that post.
She's done with that difficult post. And here's Katrin Skinner hitting nicely her 14th target. So just one target far from the gold medal match, where she will most probably meet her teammate, Laetisha Scanlan of Australia.
Oh, and Jana's hanging in there.
And Jana Beckham is in.
Yeah, so they're good.
11 hits out of 15 targets for Jana Beckham.
So right now, well, we'll have to see how it goes here.
So pressure back on Jessica Rossi. She needs to hit the last two targets to have at least a chance to have a go in the bronze medal match. So if she wants to have a chance to get on the podium, she needs to hit the next two targets straight.
Yes, and she hit that one. That was great. Hit that sharp.
And
oh,
I
no.
think it was called a no bird again. It's the fourth time that this happens to Jessica Rossi. She had, I think, three, and I think this was the fourth no bird. Let's see what the referees are deciding, because I see that she was appealing, and apparently, she will have to repeat this 14th shot, and that's frustrating, isn't it?
Well, it is very frustrating, and it would be very frustrating for her, and because she hit that, and it was that sharp left. Now, the good news is the sun is a little bit lower, so it's not quite as bad, but it's still not great. And it was that sharp left off of three, and it's a difficult.
And once again, she is confronted with this situation. She had a no bird. She knows where the target is going to fly. And apparently before that worked for her. She hit the target the second time. But let's see. Now the pressure is high when only two targets are left, two matches.
Oh, great.
And it's
she
a
hit
clear
it well.
Hit.
Yeah.
And that was a difficult target.
Yeah, it is a very difficult target. Here's Laetisha.
Laetisha Scanlan taking her time.
No, actually it was a no bird.
Was it?
Yeah.
Laetisha Scanlan mounting again, calling for the target,
fabulous.
Hitting it clearly. She's clearing this semi-final with ease.
So she is setting not doing records, but if they did, she's setting a record for the semi-final because she has shot 14 out of 14 and is shooting brilliantly. That's fabulous.
That's great. For the 2013 season, I know that the ISSF will not record the world record in the finals.
Yeah, look at Carol's concentration. Good for her. This is her last target. Oh, she wasn't ready. Good for her. Bring the gun down.
Taking her time. Deep breath before mounting the gun again.
And, you know, France has a great history in women's trap as well. You know, Delphine, Racinette Nauraud, has been an incredibly good shooter has been in the Olympics, medaled in the Olympics for France.
Carole Cormenier just finished with Ait, and now Katrin Skinner.
Katrin did brilliant.
Hitting her last target, and she will be competing in the gold medal match, the next final phase, which will determine the gold medal winner. And here's Jana Beckham.
She missed her last target.
Missing the very last target. How frustrating is that?
As that high one that's some people missed right at the beginning. A lot of people think high straightaways are easy, and a lot of times those are the ones
you miss.
I heard
a lot of people saying that looks easy, but
it's not. It isn't as easy as it looks.
And here's again Jessica Rossi for her very last target. She needs to hit this one if she wants to move on to the bronze medal match. Jessica Rossi really concentrated for this last shot.
Oh, hit it nicely.
And it's a hit. It's this was a clear hit. And pressure back now on Laetisha Scanlan, who hits the last target. Laetisha Scanlan taking part in her first ISSF World Cup final, semi-final, has been clearing this round with 15 hits straight. Charlotte Kerwood finishing with a hit. So we will have now the final results, and here they are. Laetisha Scanlan and Catherine Skinner with 15 and 14 hits respectively will advance to the gold medal match. Jana Beckham will face the 2012 Olympic champion Jessica Rossi in the bronze medal match. And this is announced to be a tough bronze medal match and gold medal match, isn't it? Charlotte Kerwood of Great Britain with 10 hits is placing in fifth, followed by Carol Cormenier with 10 hits as well. They dropped out of the competition now. So this was the semi-final for the Trap Woman event.
You know, Jana came up. They're both products of good systems. The German system is a good, has produced good women shooters. Before Jana was Suzanne Kiermaier, who was excellent. When I first started shooting in the late 60s, the best shooter in the world was the Countess von Sodden from Germany, and she was formidable. She
so
was
the
school fabulous.
Is there. The school,
oh,
the tradition
yeah.
is there.
Yeah, it really is. And I think that makes a huge difference. So you've got a school, you know, there's tradition in Italy, there's a tradition in Germany, and they've produced incredible women shooters throughout the years. I mean, Italy, you'd have to go off. You know, the first world championship I went to is 1969. Bina Avril from Italy won. I mean, there's so many amazing women Italian shooters.
And so two shooters coming from Germany and Italy, Jana Beckham and Jessica Rossi, will meet now in the bronze medal match. Here you see Jana Beckham.
She's been relaxed. You know, she's been so relaxed all day. I mean, she's been happy and she's been joking with Axel. I mean, I think she's in a really good spot.
And she does look relaxed right now, doesn't she?
Oh yeah, she did throughout the day when we were training. I mean, when we had our when we were competing in the main event.
So it will take a while now to get the range set for the bronze medal match, which will go first.
Yeah.
So take a while. They have to set the range again for the bronze medal matches. How are these medal matches being conducted?
Well, the medal matches are conducted the very same way as the semifinal, and I think that's where some people have some problems because they thought that they had set this up to make it faster, and now it's not as fast. But you know, it's interesting. The people who've been in the finals, at least the one in Acapulco, enjoyed it. It would be interesting to get feedback from the other shooters and from the people who watch ISSF TV to get their feedback.
And we will see. This is the first season with the new rules. Rules were changed at the very end of 2012, so they went into effect from 1st January 2013. Rules were used for the first time in an official international competition in Acapulco, where the first ISSF Shotgun World Cup stage was conducted last March, and this is just the second competition. And I believe we will need to wait a few matches, a few competitions before seeing the shooters getting into the new routine to evaluate the timing.
Yeah,
and the
I think so, because in Acapulco we had more like South American people in the championships and different things, and here we're having more Europeans. So once we've gone through the four World Cups, it'll be very interesting to get feedback from the shooters and from the coaches and from the spectators to what they like or not they don't like.
And here we are now into the bronze medal match. Jana Beckham shooting her very first target. As you may notice, she took her shaders out. No more sunglasses for her, while Jessica is still wearing the sunglasses. The light is still a little bit tricky at the moment.
Yeah, I think the light, it's only going to get worse. Because as the sun goes down, I mean, it's going to be harder to see the target. But it's good thing they're both young.
It's 10 minutes to 6 p.m. here in Al Ain, the venue for this competition in the United Arab Emirates. And here is Jana Beckham hitting missing the second target.
It was that sharp left off of three, and I didn't even see it from here, and I don't have a gun in front of me.
And yes, Jessica Rossi getting a right angled target and hitting it nicely. So moving on now, Jessica Rossi moves to station number two, as you can see, while Jana Beckham is getting ready to shoot in post number four. And he has the left-handed German shooter, the only left-handed shooter in today's semi-final.
She hit that straight away nicely.
And as you can see, there's still a bit of wind out there. And he has Jessica Rossi starting the bronze medal match in the best wave with two consecutive hits.
And
hitting the third one. So after the first three targets, Jessica Rossi is leading with one target of advantage over her competitor today. Her competitor,
Jana Beckman.
Jana Beckman.
So Jana ended up in Acapulco in fourth. She lost the bronze medal.
In spite of starting with the highest
score. Yeah.
Jana Beckham looking for the first podium of the season here in Alain. Calling
nice
the target.
Hit.
Nice hit. Jana Beckham has never won an ISSF World Cup medal. She qualified in 2012, last year, for the World Cup final, making up points throughout the season. And there, she managed to win a bronze medal. But she never really won a podium placement in a World Cup stage before, in spite of being around here since 2006.
Well, she's she's going for it this year.
And here's Jana Beckham calling the target. And here it comes.
Oh, high one.
She's
a little slow on that. I'm wondering if she's able to see.
And this was a miss.
Oh, yeah. No target again.
Oh, no target. So she will have to repeat this one. Once again, after the shoot-off, targets are normally throwing randomly, but after a shoot-off, you know where the target is going to be.
No, after a broken target.
Broken target again.
After a broken target, you know where it's going.
Yep. And it's a no bird again?
Yeah, no bird.
Jana Beckham.
Oh, and she hit that one.
That's a hit. Now, Jessica Rossi, can you help us to spot out some differences in the way these two shooters are actually shooting?
Oh, yeah. And she missed that one. It was the high right. So, when you watch, right now, you're seeing Jana. And she stands very straight, and she mounts the gun. It's really, she has a lovely style, and she mounts it quite high, but then she goes forward a little bit.
But
and she holds a high gun.
She's not bending too much.
No. She has most of her weight on her front leg, but she's quite
standing straight. That was a clear hit.
Yes. Now, with Jessica, she stands straight, but she has more. She has what we call the Italian style, which is she's a little bit hunched over into the gun, or the gun is into the shoulder. Hunched a bit.
So two different schools are facing here today in this bronze medal match at the ISSF Shotgun World Cup in LA, where Jessica Rossi, the reigning Olympic champion, is competing against Jana Beckham. For a bronze medal, the two shooters are now tied after the first six targets with five hits each. They both miss one target. So once again, the two athletes are competing neck and neck on their road to the podium. Nice hit from Jana Beckham.
You know, when you look at it, Jana hasn't been in the Olympics. She's doing really well this year. She's coming into her own.
Her Olympic cycle.
Yes, it is. I think it'll be an exciting time for her and the German Federation, because I think she's good, and they have, other good shooter from Germany, Katrin Uss, is it, say it, Uss?
Yes, I think
Uss,
so.
Katrin, and she did well in World Cup last year, a couple years ago. She's a good shooter, too.
Jana Beckham clearing this eighth target. Pressure back now on Jessica Rossi of Italy, calling the target and hitting it straight. We are going now in the second half of this bronze medal match. Two shooters are still tied with seven hits each. It's going to be a tough match
from
now on.
Yeah, it is. They're both shooting well. And I think it was wise when Jana took her glasses off. I think that was a really good decision.
Is it allowed for Jessica Rossi, who is still wearing the glasses, to take them off now?
Yes.
Jana Beckham. Shooting in position
nice
number
shot.
Four, a nice shot against the sun.
So what I was saying about that, you see her shoulders are a little, and then the gun comes in.
Just it. Yeah.
Still standing straight and nicely balanced, perfect balance.
But you can tell, but definitely tell that this is a different style, a different way to face the target.
Yeah.
Jana Beckham and Jessica Rossi, as you can see.
Jana back
Beckham,
to back.
Back to back. You can't really say that they are facing each other, as Jana Beckham is left-handed, the only left-handed shooter in today's match. In today's semifinals and bronze medal match. Beckham calling now her 10th target and hitting that clearly.
Yeah, both women are doing much better in this final, in the bronze medal final, than they did in the main event, the semifinal.
So after this 10th shot, they are still tied. What will happen if at the end of this bronze medal match, the two of them will be
then they'll do a missing out.
So it's a sudden death tiebreaker, isn't it?
Yeah, I believe so. Now, they've changed the rules. I believe it is.
I believe we'll find it out quite soon, as only five targets are left to the end of this competition, when Jana Beckham is calling her 12th target, and it's a clear hit. Good job.
11th target. We have six
target.
More.
And here's Jessica Rossi.
Good.
No problems for her. Jessica Rossi shooting straight after missing her fifth target. She has been clearing all stations so far.
Yeah, both women are shooting well. They're seeing it, which just amazes me, because I think it's difficult for all the spectators to see the targets, because the visibility is tough.
From here, it really looks like they found their rhythm.
How much
the routine is important in such a match?
Oh, very important. Getting your rhythm, and I think that's why the semifinals are hard for people, because they haven't learned the rhythm yet, because it's not normal. This is a
normal
way how we shoot. You know, there's no standing back. You just shoot and move. And so this is how we used to do it. So I think it's easier for them to get in a rhythm.
So after the first 12 targets, Jana Beckham and Jessica Rossi still tied neck and neck with 11 hits, one miss each so far.
Yeah, and one miss will put one of them out.
So the last three targets will probably decide this bronze medal match. And if not, we will go on with a shoot-off for the medal. Pressure is high now when Jana Beckham calls this 13th target.
Oh, that terrible
and
target.
That was a miss. Ah. As you said, that was the most difficult target today.
Oh, yeah. The sharp one off of...
Bird for Jessica Rossi. Once again, the fifth time in this final.
Yeah, anything to the left is tough right now on those three posts.
Jessica Rossi, she just faced a no-bird. She now has a real concrete chance to jump up in the lead in this bronze medal match. If she hits this target, she will be in front of Beckham by one hit, and this could be her chance to move on.
Yeah.
And yes, she goes for hit.
High
Jessica
to
Rossi
the right. Yeah.
Hitting her 13th target, building up a lead, let's say a very small lead of one target. Everything could still change, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's
how many finals have we seen changing on the last pair?
On the last target.
On the last target.
Yeah, it's a lot of finals.
And here's Jana Beckham, and no more mistake allowed if she wants to steal a chance to go.
She missed.
And
she's
here
out.
Comes another miss, and it looks like that if Jessica Rossi will eat this target, she will be our bronze medalist today. And
yes.
Here's Jessica Rossi calling the
and
target.
Another
no-bird, always to her. Always to Jessica Rossi. What an exciting final. The Italian shooter is just one target far from winning today's bronze medal, but it's not that easy still.
Boy, Jana must be so... I just can see her shaking her head. I mean, this is...
The same reaction what she had in Acapulco when she finished in fourth.
Yeah.
Must be extremely frustrating.
And to shoot so well in both places. and then to
ending up in fourth, just one target far from the podium. But let's follow now the match. The match could still change. Jessica Rossi just faced her second consecutive no bird, broken target. That means she will have to repeat that. It's probably getting a little bit nervous because it's maybe the sixth or seventh time that this happens in today's finals.
Oh, she shot
but
that well.
She shot that well, so we can say that the bronze medalist is Jessica Rossi. They will have to go through the last target, but Rossi, with 2 points, with two targets of lead over Jana Beckham, is on the podium.
Yes,
she's today's bronze medalist, the second bronze medal of the season for the reigning Olympic champion. But let's follow Beckham's last target. And she closes with a hit. Jana Beckham closing this bronze medal match with 12 hits out of 15 targets. That means she will end up in fourth place, exactly like it was, like it happened in Acapulco. And here's Jessica Rossi closing, clearing the round with 14 hits out of 15 targets. So the bronze medal goes to the 2012 Olympic champion, the 21-year-old Jessica Rossi, the young Italian shooter who is now congratulating with coach Albano Pera. It's the second consecutive World Cup bronze medal.
No, she had a silver medal in that.
She had a silver medal, I feel sorry. Yes, she had a silver medal, so it's the second consecutive podium of the year for the Italian shooter.
Great shooting.
In Acapulco, we were interviewing her, and she told us that after the Olympics, she had a few, let's say, 2-3 months off to participate in all these media events in Italy, where the sport is quite popular. And after that, she started training, let's say, after Christmas. So it was not so easy for her to start off in Acapulco, but apparently just a few weeks of trainings worked fine for her.
Yes, I mean, I think the change and the rest did her well. Did her good. I mean, she has certainly done well.
But now we are moving on to the gold medal match. Two teammates, two Australian shooters, two young finalists, Laetisha Scanlan and Catherine Skinner, 22 and 23 years old, will be competing for...
Yeah.
Will be competing for the gold medal.
He's making a lot.
So, what can we say about these two shooters?
Well, they're both good. They're young. They have great potential. I think they, in the years I've known them, they're good competitors.
And today, apparently, they had quite a good competition, leading the qualification and then the semi-finals. They advanced tied to the gold medal match, where they will shoot on 15 targets. The qualification score and the semi-final score has been set back to zero.
Yeah, it's something. You know, Laetitia is shooting well, 73 in the competition and then 15 out of 15 in the semi-final. She's really has shot extremely well. Whoops. And Catherine, you know, shot a 71, had to have a shoot-off to get into the final, and then she shot the 14 out of 15. I mean, both women are good shooters, and they're handling this very well.
And we are getting into the gold medal match. The first target, and it's a first miss for Catherine Skinner.
Just like she did in the semifinal.
She started off with a miss there, and then she moved on clearing all the targets. And Laetitia Scanlan is starting with a miss as well, so the two shooters are still tied with 0 hits at the moment.
Well, I have to tell, I mean, the visibility is really difficult.
Light has been changing dramatically in the last 5 minutes, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. It's going down, and they're going to be shooting by Braille pretty soon. But Catherine got that second one. That was good.
And now pressure back on Scanlan. And it's a hit.
That was good. I kept wondering, but yes, a nice hit.
So the two Australian teammates shooting tied here for the gold medal. None of them had been winning an ISSF World Cup medal before. Here today they are competing to decide who's going to get a top of the podium and who is going to go home the silver.
And Catherine just hit that one nicely.
And they are still wearing their sunglasses. It looks difficult now with this light. It's
well, you know, one of the coach of Slovenia was telling me that actually he didn't think the color of the lens made any difference today, which I thought was very interesting because talking to the Italian coach of another team and an American, they thought it would. So these young women are showing that maybe it doesn't. Maybe it's young eyes.
Catherine Skinner and Laetitia Scanlan still tied to each. And this is Skinner.
Oh, slow pull.
So what happened?
Oh, she called and it didn't come out right when she called, so that's called a slow pull.
So she will have to repeat that?
Yes. Yeah.
Catherine Skinner again on a fourth target, calling.
And no bird.
So
no target.
Pressure back on Catherine Skinner. She will have to repeat this target for the third consecutive time after a slow pull, as I learned today. And
no target.
And no target.
Oh, and she missed it. It's sharp right.
And she missed that target. After repeating it three times, Laetitia Scanlan hits now and she moves up in the lead. She has now one target lead over her teammate Skinner, and it will be now tough for Skinner to get back.
Yeah, but you know, it's the final of a gold medal. So for the gold medal, so who knows what's going to happen.
And here is Skinner mounting her gun.
Oh, and she missed that one as well.
Second consecutive miss.
Now, it looks like from here that when Catherine puts her gun, she holds a higher gun in relation to that trap house than Laetitia. Laetitia looks like she holds down closer to the.
Would you say it's two different shooting styles, or it's just a different way to hold a gun here today?
They're different styles, actually. If you hold a higher gun, as opposed to holding down a sight mark. But, you know, I can't see down the barrel, so I can't tell. But that's what it looks like. It looks like Laetitia holds near the white mark or, you know, on the bunker there. And it looks like Catherine holds higher.
And so after the six targets, Laetitia Scanlan is still leading this match with two shots of advantage, two hits of advantage over Catherine Skinner. It's getting tough now when nine targets are left to decide the medals. Once again, can you remind us what guns, what ammunition they are shooting?
Oh, yes. Both women are shooting Beretta's DT-11s. I believe that's a new gun out in this year. And
works fine for them.
Yeah. And Laetitia is shooting, they're both shooting RCs, but Laetitia's shooting the RC Red Shot, and Catherine's shooting the RC-4. Both are popular ammunitions.
In the trap event.
Yes. Yes, they are.
Catherine Skinner, now she seems to be back in focus.
Yeah, but it is so hard.
Missing.
See, she's holding a higher gun, and I would think that would be really difficult for her to see the target. Just because she's probably looking below the gun. I don't know because I haven't talked to her about that. But and Laetitia's holding a lower gun, so she's, I think, picking it up easier.
It's working better. Now that the light changed a lot, it's a little bit darker now, you can really see the difference between the lighting.
Oh, yeah. I mean, from shooting in bright sun during the day to now, where...
And here is...
Catherine missed it again.
Missed again.
And she's looking, thinking, what am I doing wrong?
What could be wrong out there?
Now I know she's thinking, what can I do to fix this?
And now Laetitia Scanlan has four targets of advantage when only six targets are left to be thrown. Scanlan is leading with eight to Catherine Skinner's fourth.
Yeah.
Four hits.
Yeah, Catherine has missed more in this final than she did in the whole competition.
In the old day.
The whole
Must be frustrating.
Oh, very frustrating. Trust me, I know that one. It is really frustrating.
Catherine Skinner back with a hit. Laetitia Scanlan is cruising without problems. She has a cruise control there.
Boy, she's shooting well. She, you know, and you'll notice too, she doesn't take as much time to get ready as Catherine. Catherine does take her time. She which most students do, she takes her time and calls and hit that one nicely. Now Laetisha brings it up and just calls.
She's fast. She is fast and accurate. And here comes another hit. So far, 10 hits out of 11 targets. She's going straight for the gold medal.
Oh, yes.
If she would hit the next target, she will already have the gold medal. A wonderful competition from Laetisha Scanlan. The best today. And here, Catherine Skinner, she needs to hit this target if she wants to still have a chance, and she did. And now here is Laetisha Scanlan. If she hits this one, she will have the gold medal. And
she does.
11 hits out of 12 targets. She has 4 targets of advantage over Catherine Skinner with only 3 targets to go. So she has the gold medal around her neck.
Oh, she has the gold medal, yeah. But just how well she does it. I mean, she's only missed one. And if
wonderful competition.
Oh, she's shot extremely
wonderful
well.
Competition. Now, Catherine Skinner, last three targets just to complete this final. Broken target. For Laetisha Scanlan, as I said, last three targets to go, but we already know that Laetisha Scanlan will get the gold following her teammate, younger Catherine Skinner. Will go back home with a silver around their neck.
Well, it's great for Australia. They've won the gold and the silver.
I think it has been a while since they placed 2 shooters in a podium in the same competition.
I think
in the ISSF World Cup series. And there's Catherine Skinner.
Excellent.
Eating
hit.
It nicely, but she doesn't need this. This won't help. Laetisha Scanlan keeps on hitting straight.
There's the thing called pride. You want to hit as many targets as you want.
You
want
to get to the end. You
want to hit them as many as you can.
And now last target for Catherine Skinner of Australia.
Well, I know one thing for a fact. This is not the end of our seeing Catherine Skinner or Laetisha Scanlan.
I think this is just the beginning.
I do too.
This is just the beginning. And Laetisha Scanlan clears the last targets. She closes the gold medal match with 14. It's out of 15 targets, winning today's gold medal, first gold medal in an ISSF World Cup stage. She has been doing great today. She only missed 3 targets from the morning qualification until now.
And
wonderful shooting, isn't it?
Shot 29 out of 30 in the final, the semifinal and the final. That's fabulous. That's the best done this year so far.
Great job from Laetisha Scanlan, 22 years old. She was one of the youngest competitors here. She clears this match winning the gold medal, a very first gold in the ISSF World Cup. The silver medal goes to Catherine Skinner, her teammate, while the bronze went to the 2012 Olympic champion, Jessica Rossi. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for following us. Susan, thank you for being with us today.
My pleasure.
ISSF TV will be back tomorrow with the Trap Man event taking place here at the Alain shooting range. Thank you for following us, and don't forget to log on www.issf-sports.org for all photos, results, and information about the competition.
And the Vice President of the Arabian Shooting Federation. Ladies and gentlemen, your bronze medalist representing Italy, Jessica Rossi.
Brava Jessica! Brava Jessica!
Your silver medalist representing Australia, Catherine Skinner. And your gold medalist representing Australia, Laetisha Scanlan. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem.
Jessica.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of Australia.
Excuse me.